Hi friends, here in this video we are going to see the LMTD formula for a counter flow heat exchanger. So let's get started. First, I'll draw the diagram for the counter flow heat exchanger, then explain the temperature profile step by step. Now here we are having two fluids, hot fluid and cold fluid. There will be an exchange or interchange of heat in between both of them. Hot fluid is entering from left side at temperature THI and it is leaving the heat exchanger at temperature THO. Similarly, the cold fluid is entering from the opposite end, that is from right towards left, having inlet temperature TCI, exit temperature TCO. Now just below this heat exchanger, I'll draw the temperature profile or the temperature distribution along the length of the heat exchanger. Hot fluid is entering from the left side, so it would be having a maximum temperature or the highest temperature, which is THI. Along the length of the heat exchanger, when the hot fluid it flows, the temperature goes on reducing continuously and it reaches a temperature of THO at exit. So this is the temperature variation for the hot fluid. Similarly, for the cold fluid, it is entering at temperature TCI, which is towards the right, and then when it moves along the length of the heat exchanger, it gains heat from the hot fluid, so the temperature rises and finally it reaches up to temperature TCO at exit. So at exit, the cold fluid is having high temperature. Next, the temperature difference onto the left hand side is delta T1, and on the right hand side it is delta T2. Now, after explaining the temperature variation for the hot and cold fluid, we can see they are moving in opposite directions, so it is a counter flow heat exchanger. I'll write the total heat transfer for such a condition. Since the total rate of heat transfer is given by capital Q, it is U into A into temperature difference, which is the temperature of hot fluid minus the temperature of cold fluid, where U is the overall heat transfer coefficient. Next, therefore, the small amount of heat transfer will be denoted by dQ, and it will be equal to, now in this heat exchanger which is having length L, I am assuming a small length of the heat exchanger. Now this small length of the heat exchanger which I have taken is dx, located at a distance of x from the origin. Now along this length dx, as we can see, the temperature variation for the hot fluid we have to take along the length. So this is the initial length and here there is the final length. So when I take the difference between this final value and initial value, since this value is small, DTH, that is the temperature change of the hot fluid, would be negative. Now similarly, when I check for the cold fluid along the length of the heat exchanger, here this temperature, when I am starting the length at initial condition, this temperature is greater, but finally this temperature is reduced along the length of the heat exchanger. So when we take the difference of the final value minus the initial value is greater, so this temperature change for the cold fluid along the length is also negative. Again, I'll explain that if you are analyzing this, you have to analyze it along the length of the heat exchanger. So the temperature drop, and starting from left side. So when I'm starting from left side, because here is the reference for the length of the heat exchanger, there is drop in the temperature of hot fluid, whereas the cold fluid temperature is increasing from right towards left. But we have to analyze from left to right, that is along the length. So here the final value is smaller than the initial value. So that is why DTC comes out to be negative. Next, small rate of heat transfer would be given by U is the overall heat transfer coefficient. This capital area would be small area dA, and the temperature difference here, it would be denoted by delta T. Keeping it as equation first. Next, after this, I'll write down. Heat lost by hot fluid is equal to the heat gained by the cold fluid. So this is the energy balance, and it can be written as in the form of total heat transfer, which is capital Q. So therefore the total heat is capital Q. Heat lost by hot fluid is m dot h, mass flow rate of hot fluid, specific heat of hot fluid into its temperature difference. Similarly, it is equal to the heat gained by the cold fluid, m dot c, cpc into tco minus tci, that is the mass flow rate of cold fluid, specific heat of cold fluid into exit and inlet temperature of cold fluid. So therefore Q will be m dot h into cph is called as the heat capacity, which is denoted as capital C for the hot fluid, into thi minus tho is equal to the heat capacity for the cold fluid, TCO minus TCI. So from this I can say CH will be equal to Q upon THI minus THO, and CC, heat capacity for the cold fluid, would be Q upon TCO minus TCI. So highlighting both of them, CH, this I'll give it as equation second, CC is equation third. Now after this I'll say that since the temperature difference is given by for the small length, for length dx, the change in temperature is given by dt is equal to, it is dth, the temperature change of hot fluid, minus dtc, the temperature change of cold fluid. Now after reaching up till here, dth, as we have seen, it is negative along the length of the heat exchanger. And how to get dth? It would be using the same equation which I have used, but for the small length, I can say that the small change in heat transfer dq would be the heat capacity, which is ch if I am writing for the hot fluid, into the temperature change of the hot fluid, which is dth. But here since dth is negative, so therefore dq will be minus ch into dth. So therefore dth value will be minus q upon ch. And in a similar manner, dtc is also negative, so therefore dq is equal to cc, heat capacity for the cold fluid, and the temperature difference is DTC, and along the length of the heat exchanger it goes on reducing, so it is minus from left to right we have to take. So therefore here this is also negative, so finally DTC would be minus DQ upon CC. Now putting this DTH value and DTC value over here, so therefore DTH is minus DQ upon CH, there is minus sign, and DTC is minus DQ upon CC, so that would be into the bracket minus DQ upon CC, so it would be minus DQ upon CH plus DQ upon CC. So therefore DT would be minus DQ taken common 1 upon CH minus 1 upon CC. Now this small DQ I'll get it from equation 1, it is U into DA into delta T. Next, I would be integrating this equation to get the total amount of temperature change. But just before integrating, we need to separate the variables. Here there are two variables, temperature and area. So dT divided by delta T minus U dA into the bracketed term. Next, integrating, on both sides, so here we have integration of 1 upon delta T and the limits are delta T1 to delta T2 minus U integration of dA into this bracket 1 upon CH minus 1 upon CC. So the integration of 1 upon delta T is log to the base E, that is ln of delta T, and when I put the limits it would be ln of delta T2 upon delta T1 is equal to minus U into dA is the area, which is capital A, 1 upon CH minus 1 upon CC. Now CH value is there with us in equation number 2nd. Here is the CH value, I'll put it over here, and since it is in the denominator it would be Q and THI minus THO will go into the numerator. Similarly for CC value it is Q upon TCO minus TCI, and since it is in the denominator it would be Q, and TCO minus TCI would be there in the numerator. Minus UA, this Q would be taken common, and into the bracket we have THI minus THO, this would become minus TCO when I open the bracket plus TCI. Then I'll keep the terms together in such a way that looking into the temperature variation which I had drawn previously, as we see here at the left hand side we are having THI and TCO, so I would be combining both of them, THI minus TCO, combining them. Onto the right hand side it is THO minus TCI, so here we have THO which is minus THO plus TCI, so when I take the negative common into the bracket I would be having THO minus TCI, and the left hand side will go on repeating. Next, finally THI minus TCO value, I'll go on writing it. THI minus TCO is nothing but delta T1, because I have combined the terms in such a way that we get delta T1 minus delta T2. So here is delta T1, and THO minus TCI is delta T2. So I am getting delta T1 minus delta T2. Now therefore, on this left hand side, when I make this term reciprocal, there would be a negative sign introduced. So therefore, from left hand side and from right hand side, the negative value gets cancelled out. I'll keep Q on one side, so Q is shifted on one side. Here we have UA into delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by ln of delta T1 upon delta T2. Now this entire term is nothing but called as LMTD, the logarithmic mean temperature difference. So the final formula would become So equation A gives the LMTD formula for a counterflow heat exchanger. And when we see this formula, the LMTD formula for counterflow and parallel flow, the final form is same, but the only difference comes out to be in the value of delta T1 and delta T2. In case of counterflow, delta T1 is THI minus TCO, whereas in case of parallel flow, it is THI minus TCI. And then delta T2 here is THO minus TCI, whereas in case of parallel flow, it is THO minus TCO. So the formula, final formula looks same, but there is difference in delta T1 and delta T2 values. And this LMTD formula is to be used when out of the four temperatures, we are having three temperatures are given. And one temperature can be calculated and we can use the LMTD formula. But if we have only two temperatures, mostly the inlet temperatures THI and TCI, then we have to use the ENTU method. And how the ENTU method has been derived for the parallel and counter flow heat exchangers, that I had explained in my previous video, so y'all can refer that. So this was regarding the LMTD for the counter flow heat exchanger, used to find either the rate of heat transfer or the area of the heat exchanger, or we can find the overall heat transfer coefficient. In the end, if you'll find my videos helpful, y'all can like, share, comment and subscribe our channel and share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.